Have you ever wanted to create a video and send it internally or maybe externally and you don't have the video editing software, or maybe you just want something relatively simple to send it? Well, you can now do that with AI with a Google-based application, and that's called Google Videos, which not many people know about, and it comes with powerful Gemini features. Today, I'm going to show you around it and explore the features of this application. So I think it's important before we start to see where this is available on, because it's only available through some plans that Google offer. So you can get it through the following workspace accounts, and I include a link to this page just because they are most likely to change this in the future. It does come with Gemini, which is an additional AI experience that layers on top of this to make the whole process simpler. So maybe you want to create a presentation, or you're just looking to summarize some of the information you have, or maybe even make a training document for a new employee, and you want something that's relatively easy and may already be part of your package. So as you can see here, this is what you get when you get access to the Google Video experience. And you can see here, then I'm just going to choose one of the default areas. So what you can do here is add a particular prompt that you want to start with. So it could be like this, an executive recap from a summary where senior leaders basically talk about structure for the next 12 months. Now you can go ahead and press next, and essentially it's going to generate the outline for you. We see this in other apps like Gamma AI, which help you to create the structure first, in which you can go in and edit the title of the outline. You can also add in additional topics. And what this does is you may see there's a few indicators here, like a little video that indicates that you can add video to it, and we'll come to that a little bit later. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Zapier. If you're interested in Zapier, you can find it linked below and a little bit more later into this video. So as you can see here, I'm gonna go and press next, and this is where you can go ahead and choose a style of structure. So in this case, maybe I wanna keep things pretty simple. And as you can see here, I'm gonna go ahead and generate a draft video. So I'm back with a coffee, and it didn't take that long. Don't worry. It took about 30 seconds to generate this, 45 seconds previously, but I think the internet was slightly pushed then. But as you can see here, what it's done is generated an outline. And you may see there's a few different things about this application. Down here, there's a recording that you can have be generated by notes that you write here. So you can write a simple script, and then it generates the voiceover for you. Now you can choose between actually a few different options for different voiceovers, from a narrator all the way to a motivator. And they're all different, obviously, pitches and different types of voices. So this is really cool because you can insert them into the timeline, so you don't even have to do any of the recording. But if you did want to, there is a record myself option, and you can actually choose the voiceover, or you can choose screen and camera, or camera, which is great optionality here. So if I wanted to, I could jump into this part here, and I could see that there's a video placeholder. I could either record myself, keep it, or I could find a image from the stock or the web. So it's gonna find anything of summits here, and maybe I can replace it with this actual picture of a summit if I find it suitable. But in this case, I may actually want to generate an image. So you can go ahead and generate an image based on a prompt using Gemini's image generation technology. But if you're somebody like me and wants to be able to record a short video about it, then what's gonna happen is this screen's gonna appear. A read-along, which is quite cool. You can even have it rolling so that it the text comes through and the speed is changed. And finally, you can also have it as manual, just as I have it here. So in this case, I could press record and add a section in. So this is really neat because in this case, I'm actually able to just follow the script. Our executive summit brought together senior key leaders, and etc. And if I press stop, I can go ahead and preview it or insert it or re-record it. But what's nice is when I press play now, I can go ahead down here and delete the background audio. But if I press play, and you can see I've got an interactive element of the footage that I'm all automatically able to do. Now, what's nice about this is I can actually do additional things like change the playback of when it's certain the start points from. So I can actually clip this and make this a little bit better. I can loop it. I can add an animation come in. to it, which is quite cool. And I can even choose sound options, even fade in audio as well, in case there were issues at the start. So this is really quite comprehensive. I can go up here and I can replace the video if I want. But I didn't show you these options. So you can actually choose a window that you can share at the same time, because I'm doing it. it's very deep. And you can just share a screen if you want to. So there's quite a lot of functionality in what you can actually add to each of the screens. So as you're going through this, you can scribble through the timeline, and there's a timeline optionality here where you can change and add transitions, which is quite nice. So you can also right click and do a timeline zoom, or you can do regular things you do with editing software, like adding new scenes, changing templates, or even applying styling. You can add comments. So if one of your team is replying back, you say, "This is rubbish." And that team member who has left that comment will be able to give you direct feedback within the files here. So that's the basic elements of this. And I wanted to show you another example that I've got over here, which is a bit of a longer one that is fully generated through the technologies that they have here. Ever wanted to automate things, but you lack the coding skills? You can now do that with Zapier with no code. Zapier is the leader in automation, allowing you to take your workflows to the next level with a suite of automation tools. You can go from an idea to reality in no time, setting up triggers for simple workflows and for even more advanced ones. That's why over 2.2 million companies use and trust Zapier. And thanks to Zapier for sponsoring this video. And as you can see over here, you've got some additional abilities. So you can go ahead and modify the script, but you can also browse your existing Google Drive files, which is really helpful if you've got any Google Photos or Google Drive stuff that you want to quickly drag in. So in this case, I could drag this in, and as you can see, the video is too long, so you need a 10-minute version. They have to keep under 10 minutes, so they shortened it for under 10 minutes. I don't think it actually is longer than 10 minutes. But you can start to see the benefits of doing something like this, because it's going to save you time if you've got those assets already. There are additional things, like I added a success background audio. So if I just go to here, you'll be able to hear that there's a bit of a audio track in the background. And you can choose from a wide range of music from Shutterstock, I believe they are. And you can see here there are a few narrowed down options. So you can also add in things like GIFs, you can add in stickers, Google Images, and other additional video that may help support it. So there are additional benefits to using this, because you've got the shape function, which you can still use if you're trying to demonstrate something, and the ability to connect up with lines as well. You can also add in titles and these quite cool things, which are these little sort of interactive elements. So if I was like talking and I wanted a little bit of sort of notoriety, app reviewer, and you can have that information appear on screen, which gives a little bit of a interactive element to your account. Now, at any time, you can scroll through some of the library of options for what you want this to look like. And there's some quite creative options. So in this case, you can have something that's a bit more trainer video or top five, or you could go for something a bit more corporate productivity app demo. Oh, I like this one. So you can start to get to the idea of how that works. And you can also choose the scenes that you sort as well. So additional abilities, when you're ready to share, you can go up to share up here, which means you can give access to other people to leave comments or even edit it if you want. You can also play it, which is almost like a preview, and you can see whether it's any good. And you can also see any revisions history, which means you can go back as well. Now up here, there are additional abilities to export it to Drive or to download it as an MP4 file, which I thought was pretty good. You can also modify the scene as well if you want some more details. So as well, you can also add a table or a chart, and you can import a chart from Google Sheets if you did want to, which is very helpful. You can see all of the other formatting options here, in which you can narrow down aligning and format options as well. You can also change the background, which is really good, and arrange the scene a bit more attractive. So this application is pretty good. If you've already got Google Workspace, it's actually seemingly underrated in terms of what it can offer you. There's quite a good level of abilities if you're just looking to make a simple training video internally, or you just want to get started with video editing and you don't know how to. This one's a very easy to use tool and it's great for sharing and collaborating with others, which some of the other ones don't actually get done very well. So that was an overview of Google Videos. If you're interested in more tools like this, you can jump over to toolfinder.co, which is the best place to find new software and tools. And please do check out and subscribe to our YouTube channel. It'd be great to have you, and we'll teach you all of the latest AI tools and resources. I'll see you very soon, folks, and cheerio for now.